The official start of hurricane season could be coming early next year. NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, has announced it will consider an earlier official start date for the Atlantic storm season. Normally it runs June 1 to November 30th. The revised season would start May 15th. Over the last 9 years, there have been devastating early season storms, storms that have caused at least 20 direct deaths and $200 million in property damage. And Chief Meteorologist Patrick Vaughn been talking about this as well. First off, you brought up a map that we don't like to see that takes us back to 2020, a lot of memories with all of those storms. Were any of them before June 1st?
Two of them.
Two of them were.
Yeah.
Okay, and you said this has been a trend you've seen several years.
Seven out of the last 10 years, I believe.
So does this change make sense?
Well, yeah, I guess so, if that is the trend that we're going into. And this lines up with the Eastern Pacific. Their season starts in mid-May also. Otherwise, it was certainly an active year last year, and this was a La Nina year. And unfortunately, we're going to start the 2021 hurricane season on a La Nina year. But there is also evidence that this may go towards near normal water temperatures in the eastern Pacific. So that would be during the peak of hurricane season. That would hopefully happen and give us a less active season. But right now, watching rains certainly moving into Tyler County, watching this back edge to see if it festers up and becomes more pronounced. That's what high-res modeling is showing, that this will become more active over towards Houston, and then that affects the triangle. But as you can see, up towards Tyler County right now from Comanill back over towards Woodville, seeing moderate rains lifting over towards Danbee at this present time. Otherwise, we've got cloudy skies all across southeast Texas. The Horseman Store, they're looking at 58 degrees on the Roofing 911 SkyCam network. Above normal temperatures are expected not this week, but the 8 to 14 day forecast, well above normal. And the next few days are going to see chilly mornings with near normal low temperatures then as we head towards this weekend. Chilly day tomorrow, then a little bit of a warm up as we head towards Thursday, and maybe a little bit of a cool down, but near normal temperatures expected as we head towards Sunday and Monday. Rainfall tonight and tomorrow morning at most is a half an inch or less. It's what all the forecast models are showing. Then we dry out coming up Tuesday afternoon, Wednesday, and Thursday. So Futurecast is going to show that this activity off towards the southwest will increase and then affect the triangle as we head towards late tonight. Regardless, we're at 60 degrees on the Golden Triangle Emergency Center Weather Watcher Network. It's 58 in Port Arthur. Lynn over in Mauriceville reporting 58, 60 currently in Orange. Further to the north in Woodville, Travis reporting 53. Stacy at Old Salem reporting 57 and 57 into Jasper. Temperatures are chilly across the state, but not mind-blowing. They're in the 40s and 50s. A lot of the 40s are a result of rainfall across the area. Notice these lines. That is isobars. When they're tight together and close together, that means breezy conditions, and that's why we have those wind advisories across southeast Texas for winds gusting at times to 30 miles an hour. Hey, we just took an elevator up to around 18,000 feet. Upper level low pressure, trough of low pressure over to North Texas has energized the subtropical, causing lift over our area. This disturbance will cruise through the Red River Valley, keeping rain in the forecast tonight. There's hopes that this will move out quick enough to allow us to see the sun set coming up tomorrow night. So the rain's picking up, as you can see, as we head towards mid and late tonight across the triangle, maybe a half an inch of rainfall. And then things start winding down after about 3-4 o'clock in the morning with a chilly morning across southeast Texas. It's going to be blustery in the morning as temperatures stay into the 40s. This is a little bit fast for my taste. I think we may slow this down as far as clouds decreasing across the area, keeping temperatures into the 50s. On the Gulf of Mexico tomorrow, looking at choppy seas around 2 to 4 feet in your coastal marine forecast with a northeast wind at 15 to 20. Our forecast tonight, 80% coverage of rain. Chilly and breezy, lows mid-40s lakes, near 50 in the triangle. Tomorrow, 40% coverage of morning showers, then maybe some decreasing cloudiness late, highs mid to upper 50s. So again, about a 40% coverage. There's hopes we can get some sun tomorrow and warm things up. Gorgeous weather expected Wednesday and Thursday. Chilly mornings, beautiful afternoons. Chance of showers returns to the forecast coming up on Friday, about a 30 to 40% coverage. Then a gorgeous weekend returns thanks to our latest cold front, and we start warming things back up with a southeast wind flow by next Monday.